Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. We finally got our compressor back, and I don't know if I think I've shown it to you. This is it right here, okay? The Iwata Studio Series Sprint Jet. This puppy does all sorts of great work. Now let me show you something really fast. See this? This is the moisture trap. And here we go. I'm removing the moisture trap. All right. And normally I put a little, paper towel in there, and it's of course soaked, so it gives you the idea, an idea of how humid and moist the temperature is. So I usually dry it and put another one in there, just so that it keeps things pretty dry, I don't normally put the whole thing in. I just put in a little piece, maybe, and it really does help soak up a lot of that moisture. Okay, and this is also the dial right here. There we go. So I'm keeping the PSI around, I'd say 25-30. I'm spraying primer. I'll show you that in just a moment. Okay, and this sucker's pretty quiet. Okay, it's pretty quiet. And again, you dial the PSI. Okay, right there. That's about 25-30. Okay. And I've had that sucker for 5 years. We are trying out the Iwata Neo, which is going to be the airbrush of this build. Okay, we're doing everything with this airbrush. I've got this handy dandy little stand that I keep over here just for in between coats. I am using Vallejo acrylic polyurethane black primer. Very good stuff. And normally I would do my plastic coat, but the weather hasn't been holding. It's been raining. I don't feel like decanting paint right now. And also that I want a little bit of control over how thick. I mean, I really do want all the details to show up in this build. So, without further ado, let me show you. We've got the tire. Remember the tire? It's magnetized, right? And my little holder here is magnetized. And so we're gonna show you the tire, and then maybe show you a couple of other parts, and we'll go from there. Right now we are in the primer stage. That's the update. All right. We're using once again the Iwata Neo. Fantastic little airbrush. You can't beat the price. Well, you can if you go for the Pache H set, but remember that's single action. This is double action. So here we go. All right, we always test our spray, and now we're going very light. Light. I kept wondering why is all of this stuff coming out. We needed to turn on the. There we go. So you just go a little light, okay? And the beauty of the double action, of course, is that if you just press down, air comes out and it helps dry the part. So you dry it a little bit. I also use a hair dryer, and then we hit it up again, making sure that we're getting smooth, full coverage. Notice how the part's not coming off of the alligator clip. Magnetization. I love these dowels because you could keep turning the part, which is important for full coverage, smooth coverage. Okay, and then once again, notice how nothing is coming out. because I just have it, the trigger pressed down. All right, so, so far so good. I'll show you a couple of other parts and we'll go from there. All righty, my friends, more coming up. Now, folks, just a little reminder. I am shooting acrylics here, okay? And you also saw Scott shooting his primer the same way. Sometimes we have to, in order to talk into the camera without having to do voiceover, which for me is kind of a pain, we often can't use our mask, our respirator, otherwise, you know, we wouldn't be able to say anything. So keep that in mind. Please protect your lungs and protect your hands. These paints are pretty much, and this primer are, you know, friendly, but I still don't want to inhale it, okay? And if you get it on your hands, that's okay. They're water washable, and it's not a big deal. But that, try not to inhale any kind of paint. Get into the habit of not inhaling any paint, any resin, residue, any of that. Speaking of resin, as you saw, these are taking, these are the Dark World Creations resin parts, and they're taking the primer very, very well. Again, the primer, which I have a variety of colors, you know, goes on smooth, and it sticks on there, and it provides a great tooth for the impending paint. The rust foundation this time around, I'm going with Come Art, okay, and I have their little kit here. It's the only kit that I have of theirs, but I really like it. I like their rust colors, and yeah, and again, it's a very thin paint. It allows you to build up layers, so it's very friendly to this build. So that's what we're working with. And anyway, I'm gonna show you a larger part. We're gonna paint the chassis black, and you'll see me change the color of the primer here from gray to black, black to white. Sometimes ruddy brown and sometimes olive green, depending, you know, on the mood I'm in, but also that I'm trying to achieve different effects. The reason why I love to use black primer is that it covers everything, okay? So it lets you know about coverage. And second, it really provides a great foundation for shadow work. Shadowing is very important. So on a tire, you know, it just provides the perfect foundation for it, and you'll see it. I'll probably use it in the cab, and the part fell off, which is fine. It was magnetized, so there it is again. Be careful, and so, you know, we'll walk you through a couple of more parts, and then after that, we'll resume with the actual painting. Right now we're in the primer stage, so stay tuned in for more, my friends. Stay tuned in. Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here. Well, so far so good. The Iwata Neo has really risen to the challenge, and it's doing an absolutely wonderful job. As you can see here, I've got the chassis mounted on my usual double-sided tape and chopstick, and of course some of the parts that are magnetized keep sticking to the magnet. That's what magnets do. So I am going to go ahead and shoot this in black. Again, we are looking for shadow or shading, as some of these artistic folk call it. And we'll see how it turns out. Now this chassis has a lot of work that went into it, and so we're hoping it'll look pretty darn good. This is just the beginning of the process. So let me walk you through a little bit of, again, some Iwata Neo work with Vallejo Black Primer. All right, let me turn on the booth, the compressor, and here we go. We always test it, and then, you know, notice, look at the way that I do it. There's nothing difficult about it. It's like, think of roasting a pig on a spit. You just keep turning it. You keep turning it. The Iwata is doing a fantastic job of spraying very smooth paint. You can see how it's covering. And again, I do very light coats. I'm changing the angle, okay, so that you get full coverage. And this primer is going on very, very thin. So you just have to keep turning it. All angles, all sides. All right. So we have a first coat, so to speak, on here. Let me turn this off. All right. So, you know, it's not complete coverage yet. I like to sort of, you know, again, add coats and coats of primer, very light, very smooth, and so that's it. So stay tuned in for more Cranky Show, my friends. More fun with the zombie baiter coming up.